Parlamento ha una sua solita per capire il jefe del Stato Maggiore delle Forze Armate, il segretario generale della Presidenza, il senatore Papadopoulos, il senatore Fantaselli, la senatora Surani, la direttora della delegazione diplomatica del primo ministro, il senatore Papadopoulos, direttore del senatore.
The weather has something.
No, it is raining these days,
yeah, but I think it would be better tomorrow when you have a chance to visit Lesbos.
It was a sun, no? It was not raining.
It would get better.
Yeah, yeah.
You brought us a sunshine.
You prepared a good welcome to us. It is really a pleasure to be here in Greece. For me, it is the second time that I came once. Was in the 90s, but for a private visit.
Oh, just the second time?
Yeah. It is the second time.
And we have very strong memories of the visit of His Holiness back in 2016.
Yes.
When he came, of course, during the refugee crisis. And I am sure that tomorrow when he will go to Lesbos, he will see a much improved situation.
Yes, somebody told me that the situation has completely changed.
It has completely changed.
Why? Because now
we put a lot of effort. First of all, we have created decent facilities for the people who end up on our islands. Because as you are well aware, the previous camp Moria was a horrible place. So now His Holiness will visit what is still a temporary facility, but it is clean, it is decent, and it offers people who have gone through, you know, horrible difficulties the opportunity to apply for asylum in conditions that are acceptable. And of course, the intention is to build permanent facilities on all our islands and to cooperate with the European Union to make sure that this actually happens. And, of course, Greece is a country that has welcomed many refugees in the past, and we will continue to do so. At the same time, we need to work with Turkey to make sure that we further reduce the flows and go after the smugglers who essentially instrumentalize the pain of desperate people. What we want to do is also to make sure that we open legal pathways for migration. For example, we welcomed more than 700 Afghani women and their families to Greece. We've been extremely generous in making sure that we offer them international protection.
Protection, yes. They came straight from Kabul.
They came from Kabul through,
to other
countries.
Because I think that now it's very difficult to come out from Kabul, no, and to arrive.
It was a complicated operation. We cooperated with also reputable international non-governmental organizations, and I had the chance to meet some of these women and their families. Really desperate what is happening in Afghanistan after all the progress that was made in terms of women's rights, but we felt we had a moral obligation to help them and their families.
Yes. I think that I met with some students, girls students coming from Kabul, and also we offered them hospitality in one of the colleges in Nairobi, but only few of them. But there are at least 50 girls who were enrolled in the Sapienza in Rome,
yes.
In the university, yes. Anyway, the question of migration is a very, very, very delicate question.
It is.
I was not really aware, for instance, that in Cyprus is a big thing.
Cyprus is small. And as a proportion of the Cyprus population, the number of people who arrive are very, very significant.
And they arrive from
Turkey, all of them.
Middle East?
They go through Turkey and then they end up in Cyprus.
Yes, yes, I
mean, there are, you know, Syrians, Afghanis, also more, also from sub-Saharan Africa.
Η σύζυγός μου, να σας γνωρίσω. Βλέπετε τον στολισμό παντούφια. Και ελπίζουμε να είναι πιο ευχάριστα Χριστούγεννα από τα περσινά.
Και σπέρω,
Ας ρωτήσουμε για την πανδημία μας έχει ταλαιπωρήσει όλο το πάνω.
Πώς θα θέλαμε, πανδημία, μετά από τον ίδιο τρόπο σώμα.
Κάνουμε μια μεγάλη προσπάθεια να αυξήσουμε τους ρυθμούς του εμβολιασμού.
Είστε στο στρατόδιο, με μεγάλη προσπάθεια να αυξήσουμε τους ρυθμούς του εμβολιασμού. Είστε στο
στρατόδιο, με μεγάλη προσπάθεια να αυξήσουμε τους ρυθμούς του εμβολιασμού. Είναι ήδη δύο χρόνια που παλεύουμε για την πανδημία.
Και προσπαθούμε βέβαια να βοηθήσουμε και χώρες στην Αφρική, στέλνοντας εμβόλια όπου μπορούμε, γιατί αναγνωρίζουμε ότι η πανδημία δεν θα αντιμετωπιστεί αν δεν αυξηθεί ο εμβολιασμός σε όλο τον κόσμο, όχι μόνο στις πλούσιες χώρες.
Una grande casa di popoli democratici. Mi riferisco all'Unione.